This is CQ's Leg Up, where every week CQ reporters give you the inside scoop on the big stories they're following. Let's start with a topic that has consumed Washington lately, healthcare.
For virtually every Republican, a government plan is a non-starter.
The bottom line is this: the current system is unsustainable.
CQ healthcare reporter Drew Armstrong says it will be a week of mostly behind-the-scenes negotiating in both chambers of Congress as moderate and liberal Democrats tussle over key elements of a healthcare reform bill.
I think it's going to be important to watch the Finance Committee in the Senate. That's really where that battle is being waged most fully. In the House, the leadership has such a strong hold over what happens that a lot of times they can, you know, push policy priorities through, whereas the Senate, it's a much more diverse collection of voices that influence things. So I think the Finance Committee, with Chairman Baucus, he's working very hard to bring in a coalition of moderates and moderate Republicans and members of his own Democratic caucus to try to craft a compromise bill. I think that he's sort of the fulcrum that all that is being played out upon.
The intent, of course, as the gentleman knows, based upon our discussions, is that we will finish all 12 appropriation bills individually between now and the 30th of July.
On the floor, CQ House leadership reporter Edward Epstein says to expect more drama as Republicans and Democrats continue to battle over appropriations bills.
Well, this week, more fireworks are likely in the House as they consider two big appropriations bills, the Homeland Security Appropriations Bill and the Interior Environment. Last Thursday, the Republicans staged a historic protest in the House. They forced a record 53 roll call votes. The previous record was 40, set like in 1988, over the restricted rule under which they could offer amendments. And Majority Leader Hoyer says that this week, the Republicans are likely to face a similar structured rule. At the end of this week, they will have done three of the 12 appropriations bills, and Hoyer says the House is not going to leave for its August recess until all 12 are done. He says they, if need be, they'll come in on weekends to finish all the work.
That's why I'm committed to passing comprehensive immigration reform as President of the United States.
White House correspondent Adriel Bettelheim says the President will finally hold a twice-delayed summit on immigration reform, once again bringing to the forefront a controversial issue that he has promised to confront.
Well, I think they want the people to primarily know that they haven't forgotten about the issue, that they have some sort of a means where they want to ensure citizenship for the many illegal aliens in the country who are working. And I think it just syncs up policy to a big campaign promise from last year. But obviously it's an issue that divided the Republicans, has the potential to divide the Democrats. And you've got such a crowded agenda already, it's hard to imagine how they're going to wedge it in with huge health care bills and energy bills taking up so much of the bandwidth, not to mention the appropriations bills in the Congress.
Follow the coverage of all these stories and more on CQ Politics and CQ.com. This is Andrew Satter saying see you next Monday on CQ's Weekly Leg Up.